In this video, we're going to be looking at the Granular Solid tool in the green shelf set. First, we're going to drop down a test pig head geometry, so hit the Tab key and type pig, and then hit the Enter key twice. Hit the T key and middle mouse button click and drag to move it higher. Now we'll need a ground plane to catch the head when it falls, so go to the rigid body shelf and click on ground plane. Let's turn off visibility on the ground plane. And deselect by clicking in the workspace and hitting the S key. Now we'll turn the head into a granular solid. Click on granular solid and then click on the head and hit the enter key. And now you can see that our head has been turned into a mesh of grain particles. If you hit the W key for wireframes, you'll see that a point constraint network has been generated for us. These points will allow the pig head to deform, but still maintain its shape as a whole. And now let's take a look at the network that's been generated. Hit the L key. And we're going to take a look at the grain update node. It's already selected. Now if we go to the particle separation and change the value to 0.02, we're going to end up with a smaller particle size. A smaller particle size will mean a higher degree of accuracy in deformations, but this will also result in longer sim time. So let's keep it at 0.06 for this example. And we're going to take a look at some of the key parameters that you should take note of. Explicit constraints, for example, will be for those doing advanced simulations, as these options will allow you to work directly with the point constraint network that we saw earlier. Also, for simulations with a tremendous amount of energy, you should work with the stiffness parameter. Otherwise, you won't see any difference in your geometry at values of, say, 1, 10, or 100. And now let's scroll back up and take a look at some other key parameters. Internal collisions in particular, shock scaling power, will produce something of a squash and stretch result. We'll leave it at the default settings for now. Okay, let's go to the Solver tab and enable Use Opencl. This will reduce sim time considerably, but will only work with graphic cards that support it. And now let's go back up to object level with the U key. And now we're going to turn off visibility on the sand particles node. Hit the L key to organize and locate the node. And we'll turn off wireframe unshaded. And we're ready to hit play and check out how our granular solid will react. Let's turn on real-time toggle and hit the up arrow key to play it back. And we've got a sort of rubber head effect. Let's stop and take a look at a pre-cut sim. We're getting all sorts of jiggling and flapping here, which is the result of a point constraint network working to maintain its shape. Let's rewind to frame 1. We'll change the shock scaling power to 30, and let's see what we'll get. In the sand update node, go to Behavior tab and change the shock scaling power to 30. The shock axis should point in the direction that grains pile, so with gravity downwards, we want Y, but you can change it depending on what result you wish to achieve. Okay, let's go back up to object level with the U key and hit the up arrow key to play. Oh, already we can see that the geometry is getting stretchier than last time. Let's see the pre-cooked sim. You can get some pretty interesting results playing with the shock scaling power and other internal collision parameters, as well as those in friction. And that's the granular solid tool inside Houdini.